Now, most of them have detached from the country per se. They don't want, you know, we have a lot, but they do not, you know, feel patriotic because whatever the reasons they've left on whatever grounds. How can we change that and get that help also? And how did you do that during the time when you were trying to get Mars a global brand and trying to pitch to the world? Was it just a local effort or was that a international effort in your case?
Actually, I didn't have to really face that situation because our joint venture partners were doing all the marketing part of it, either Victoria's Secrets or Courtauld's. So we were trying to be best in class in manufacturing for all the brands because we didn't have a brand per se. So I basically didn't have to encounter that, positioning it to the world in terms of marketing, but because the brands themselves are very strong in their markets. But we want to show that if you manufacture in Sri Lanka, it's very ethical and we take care of our workers. We take care of our, social responsibilities. We take care of our environment. And we went on to win a lot of awards for those. And positioned ourselves as great manufacturers. So I didn't have to take on the diaspora or anybody.
What do you think
else
right now? Because right now we have, if you just look at politically or economically, one of the biggest issues Sri Lanka is facing at the UNHRC. Our image has been completely destroyed there. But, you know, we have lots of Sri Lankans coming out there with the Sri Lankan flag protesting against all that. But yet the message is not going indoors to the United Nations, to the UNHRC. They are still looking at us as we are killing Tamils here, we are murdering them, massacring them, doing all that. How can we, when we are talking about resetting, when we are talking about a united front, we need to get their assistance as well. What are your thoughts on those things?
First, I think Sri Lanka must come as united. We ourselves internally, before we take on anybody else outside, are we united? If you look at a lot of things, Sri Lanka in my lifetime has never been united. The only two examples that I give when I talk is when Sri Lanka played Australia in 1996. For 24 hours, we were Sri Lankans. Muthaiah Muralidharan was not Tamil. Sanat Jayasurya was not from the south. Arjuna Ranatunga was not an Anandian. And Vas was not Catholic. We played as Sri Lanka. I can remember when I took Anuruddha Ratnayake for the Olympic Games, for 8 minutes, Sri Lankans prayed for him. Our factories of nearly 75,000 people came 1 hour before and chanted Pirith, before the fight, which came as a shock to me. So your sports have been a great unifier. Yeah. Other than few instances like that, the tsunamis that we hit in 2004, etc., Sri Lanka has never been united. They are either divided by politics, they are divided by religion, they are divided by caste, they are divided by schools. My job when I was a corporate guy was not to bring Sri Lanka together. My job was to bring my companies together. And we use sports, music, which is a great unifier to bring people together. We are Sri Lankan and we are resilient and we can do it. We can get an Olympic medal. And that means not only the boxers, not only the other athletes who were with me, we as a team created that. We didn't care whether they were from Kandy or down south or whether they went to Royal College. It didn't matter. Sri Lankans, we want to carry that flag. We want to make them competitive. And you have to change them by, first of all, we used to run and sing the national anthem in every factory. Every factory, whether they're in the north, south, every morning, we sing the national anthem. I have seen our national players not being able to sing the national anthem. They don't put the hand into the heart like All Blacks or any other players, right, and sing the national anthem. Not with the passion. So we need to create that before we take on the diaspora, because they will turn and say, look at the guys, what are you talking about? You all are fighting by different issues. We should ban all these political parties with different names. You know, we are Sri Lankans, like Singapore. Take the tough action and law and order. So we need to get them first. Respect for everybody. Then we can take on the world and say, look, we are Sri Lankans. We want to bring people together. We want to bring that respect together.